Aquarius, this is your tarot reading. Full on the back of the card deck. Nine of Wands. As a theme of the reading, crossed by Eight of Pentacles, Queen of Wands, that tarot card, Four of Swords in the near future, Devil in the past, conscious level, King of Cups, King of Cups, okay, Justice in reverse, Ten of Wands, Six of Swords. Ten of Wands is for how you, how everyone else is seeing it. This is in reverse, is how you are seeing this. Okay, wow, I already get some information about it. Hierophant in the near future, yeah. Okay. Devil in the past. Something kept you really there, like you couldn't set your mind to something else than thinking about it. So it stayed stuck in your mind. Queen of Cups to clarify it, and Knight of Cups for your person. Okay. In the first place, this maybe was about love, about a person, about this person you couldn't get them off your mind. Could be about love, could be about just understanding this person deeply from all kinds of, you know, perspectives. I think here the empathy was big. Maybe it was even in love with this person, or maybe it's still like that because I get Queen of Cups and King of Cups both in upright. And what I got with Justice in reverse is that you probably think something of this person that's not true, or that's what other people did to you to start to make that you believe this about that person. Maybe you blame other people for this, Aquarius. But where did it happen? Did you believe? Why did you believe this in the first place? That's also, you know, people see this, that you're taking responsibility for it. Like, okay, it's my fault, it's my fault. All the time, oh, it's my fault. It's all my fault. It's because of me. I think this person in the past already had a lot of feelings for you as well. Not completely developed yet in a way that they could say, I can be with you, you know, that they can be with you for long term, like in a long term relationship, but they already had that feelings for you. So it could be that you was intimate with this person, and what I mean with that, Aquarius, is that there was more, like you added a little more to this connection. So there was a connection between the both of you, not only mentally, not only emotionally, but also physically, that connection. So probably I feel with Queen of Cups and Knight of Cups also spiritually. Does this matter? It matters a lot. If this wasn't there, the story was completely different. I probably came up here with a completely different story. So what's influencing the complete reading is the Queen of Wands in reverse. Let's clarify Queen of Wands in reverse for Aquarius. Six of Cups in reverse and Queen of Pentacles in reverse. I have to say, when at the moment I'm starting YouTube or uploading videos, not always like that, but it has also to do with the devices of other people. So for some reason people turn on their devices or activate other devices, so that seems to be also a message for you, Aquarius, and it makes you feel sick. Or it makes them feel sick, because it has a very low noise. It makes very low noise that is hurting physically. So you feel sick because of it. So it's that has to do with something that is you become sick of it. So physically, you're not able doing things like you do normally. It's taking energy away. It's like killing me softly. Okay. King of Cups. Let's clarify King of Cups on your conscious level. Two of Cups and Two of Swords in reverse. So with the Queen of Wands, it's influencing the whole reading. It's more so that because of that, this is maybe a reason to fight, or you feel that it's not even worth it, the fight. Because it's like people want to keep you down in something. They don't want you to become better, or to use to see your full potential. It's like people do not want to see this. It could also indicate jealousy, but for me, jealousy is it's very di I find it very difficult to explain what is jealousy actually, because it there's much more under it. Like, why is this happening? Is this really because of bad intentions towards another people or person, or does this has to do with a certain mindset and certain delusions you have over someone or something? I think it's not something that like, for example, yeah, the feeling of feeling confidence is more clear than you can see it in your posture, in the things you do, in the results of it. But jealousy is not clear. It doesn't tell yet everybody's doing something else when they are jealous. It also manifests different ways, and I think with jealousy, it's often used, I think, in the past for women, not for men. So it's still, for me, it's still a word from the past that is used against women that are not following the orders and are not agreeing with it. For example, that their husband is cheating. But they have a reason for it, why this is like that. It has practical reasons, okay? So it has to do with that you're not feeling sick, that you can still, it has to do with your life and your health. So do they care about your health, Aquarius? Do they care about your health? Or are they really not caring and not using any protection, having sex with everyone, and then you are the one, is dying from it, for example? Is that love? Can you trust someone like that? It's very practical. With the King of Cups, yeah, you have like, okay, yeah, you're like, okay, maybe in a situation like that, you would also be jealous. Whatever it means to you, Aquarius, what jealousy means. King of Cups clarified by Two of Cups and Two of Swords in reverse. You're like, okay, I'm on the same page with this person. I totally understand maybe why they're jealous, or in that meaning of the word. And this person already made a decision. I feel that someone's really here taking the blame for a lot of things. So, they are taking the blame. They're like, it's me, it's my fault, I did it. Yeah, it's me. Even if they know it's not, they just take the blame. With the Ten of Wands, a lot of responsibility is being taken. I don't see a group of people, but there are a lot of court cards. The Queen of Wands, King of Cups, and Queen of Cups. So there's two times feminine energy and one masculine energy, and whatever that also means, you know. I know, like, man and woman, like, a man has different genitals than a woman, and there's probably, you know, the hormones are in different balance in the body, but in the brain, the videos that I can see and the information that I get is that there's no difference between the brain between a man and a woman. That is what I can see, that's what I can find online. There's no difference. And so maybe it's about these hormones. I don't know. But it's also, you know, about a word like jealousy. And is this a manipulation technique? Is what I, you know, that's what I'm, that's also when, during my whole, all my readings, since I think 2019 I'm on YouTube and 2014 I started my website, healingsworld.net. I have difficulty with that word, but because people use it, and yeah, it is a word that exists, so it is, it has a meaning attached to it. And so personally, I think this is about that meaning, what I told you. It's about, you know, women that they couldn't stand up for themselves because of a word. So it's a fictional idea, non-fictional, fictional. It's an idea, a concept to hold people back in doing something or saying something. So it's a way to mute someone. Okay, without asking what's actually going on down there. Why do you feel this? What happened before that they say to you that you're jealous? You're just jealous is, you know, also at the moment when someone responds in a way that you think, why are they responding suddenly in this way? So actually the person who's telling the other person that they're jealous is actually shocked by their response, and they project it onto this person. So there's also people who saying, oh, I feel really jealous at the moment. Feeling jealousy is, I don't know how this can manifest. Maybe in result of anger, because of the fire, you know, that is, so maybe taking certain actions that they regret afterwards, or being too fast. We're judging or projecting onto someone. So it comes probably with a lot of thoughts. Okay. I also don't see the Queen of Swords. So for you, Aquarius, I think there's something... something lacking here. Like, for example, the meaning of the words. Like, what does it actually mean? Okay. So, also... thought was running to my mind when I started this reading was, there's a lot of things, you know, that are actually political and doesn't have anything to do with reality. I mean, pieces of land are being called a country, right? And some countries are colonized, so you have people in a country with different skin color, and people are saying like, oh, you are not from this country, right? Where are you from? But that country is colonized, or that country colonized other countries, like in the Netherlands and Great Britain, for example, and France. So when someone in the Netherlands is going to another country that's colonized and it's still from the Netherlands, and they say, well, I'm Dutch. Because even when they are going to that country, they're still in the Netherlands, still colonized. You know, look, I'm not, you know, I'm not in politics, so I just use this as an example. So can you feel it, Aquarius? So this person can say they're from that country, but they also can say they're from the other country that colonized the other country, because political, it is correct, and it is a political concept. So in that framework, it's completely correct. Calling these names are made up for a reason, right? So yeah, sometimes people like to name things to own it. Okay, so it's also the other way around. If you're saying, for example, to your partner, you're jealous, it means that there's a connection between two people. They know each other, or they know what they're doing, if you don't know them personally. So they're aware of each other. That's the only thing that it means, between two people. Right? Okay, or is it more? Just let me know in the comments, Aquarius, if you know. Four of Swords in the near future. Let's clarify Four of Swords. When this person that has a colonized country grew up in the country that colonized their country, and they don't even know how to speak their language, and they have a passport of their country that colonized their country, right? Like, and then, you know, still, it's all in the political system. It's still all. So, for example, you fell in love with someone, they were from a different country, and you was like, okay, this person is really jealous, so they behave in a way that you don't like, with other words. Okay, they did something, or they're not agreeing with you, and you're not agreeing with them. But did you talk about this? And it's possible that at the moment you think, okay, well, then we have a divorce. And maybe you even think, well, I never thought that I would end up with someone from that skin color anyway, because maybe that's just what you grew up with. So subconsciously, you still have ideas that you cannot be with certain people for a longer period of time. And it's possible that you have also this idea with money or other things that you grow up with this blueprint of you will never get rich, for example, or you will never, you know, so all these things that you can heal that as well with EFT tapping. You can let it go, and there's also other techniques you can use to release this. All these beliefs that are holding you back, and you might even get into a divorce because of this. So it's not something small. These beliefs are quite like leading you. It's, you know, it's telling a lot about how your life will turn out. So if you know what the problem is, you can solve it. So when you know what the problem is, you're already for 50% there. You're already 50% at where you want to be. So is it really a bad thing if someone's telling you what your problem is? I mean, science, you know, they love problems, because then they can look into it. Or, you know, someone who's repairing products, tech, like gadgets and stuff like that, they love problems because they earn money with it to solve them. And they can feed their family with this money. Just as in reverse. I don't know why you need to know this, Aquarius. You're watching this and I'm doing a reading. Okay, so it doesn't have anything to do with me. I'm reading here. I tell you what I know. Maybe it can help you. Okay, just as in reverse. Page of Wands in reverse and Page of Swords. Okay, so it's possible, Aquarius. Someone told you something and you was like, wow, how dare someone tell me something like that? Okay. Wow. Okay. Whoa. Okay. Is someone muted here? Or are you dealing with a Pisces? Because I did one reading that was called Unmute Pisces. So there's someone that is being in a corner right now, put in a corner. How do you say that? Like they cannot. Maybe this is a man, okay? This is a man and they cannot tell anymore because, you know, maybe I've been put in a corner by you telling them they're jealous and so they're muted. They cannot say anything anymore because this is a technique to, you know, to drive someone into that corner while they didn't even tell their story. So it's possible, you know, maybe this is one of your clients. And you need to help them and you don't know how. Or this is maybe your partner. Okay, Ten of Wands clarified by Death and Nine of Swords. Yeah, so I think with all your energy, everything you try to now to take on this responsibility, but at the same time, I think this other person is worried. They are not anymore telling you something. Maybe they have difficulty speaking up about this because they're worried already when they think of it, if they would. Okay, Six of Swords. So I think here it seems to be very important, Aquarius, to talk about it, like why this person is actually told you this, and that you're sorry maybe for telling this to this person, and that you don't know what actually the reason is why they told it to you. Four of Swords clarified by Five of Pentacles and Ace of Cups. So in this reading, you are watching this, so I'm not going to blame another person because you cannot do anything, you know, you cannot change another person, but you can do something about it yourself. And I think that EFT tapping will also really help you know, to get through that barrier and also to find out how are you going to communicate this. Four of Swords clarified by Five of Pentacles and Ace of Cups. Yeah, so this break makes that you're starting to miss each other. This person really loves you, Aquarius. The Ace of Cups shows up for them. Okay. So I think this break that you had seems to be very healing between the both of you. Because you start to realize what this person means to you. Could also be business-wise, okay? It doesn't have to be love-related. Six of Swords, clarified by Three of Cups in reverse and Lovers in reverse. Okay, so in your hopes and fears, you hope that you can move on from this and that you can continue. So you hope you can continue because, yeah, that was holding you guys back. Okay, so in the end of the reading, future position, Hierophant. I have the feeling this is becoming better, okay? Something's becoming. Something's healing. And this is a tarot reading, okay? This is not to cheer anyone up. This is what I can read. So I don't know what your situation is, Aquarius. Who you are, I also don't know. I don't give a shit. You know, this is coming up, so I trust that this is, you know, this. If you keep watching this, this is what you needed to see. And then it's helping you. And what I get as an end result is that this will heal. So you feel, what I feel like, you feel a little lighter. You feel more. I don't think, I think even physically you feel better. So this makes you sick, this certain thing. So in the future position, I think you have to, it's the challenge to not get real emotional over this and then say things. Because when you're getting emotional, often you're choosing a different words than, and also different actions than when you are keeping that goal in mind. And so in that case, it's better to not be in the moment, or to be in the moment in a way of recognizing and being self-aware. So I think for Aquarius, it's very important to be more self-aware in a situation. And to know what kind of influence your words, your actions and everything have on a person. Maybe this is something you did in the past, you know, but still something within you is, there's still something around that topic coming up in this reading. And I also think that you start to realize that this is something that you thought before. You thought like, okay, but this is crazy, then you have to divorce, then you have to stop the connection. Even when you love someone, then you have to quit, then you have to run away, then you have to and someone's not worthy of you. But that, it seems to turn out that this is maybe the essence of a relationship that everyone is dealing with, and it's about the solutions, finding a solution for this. I think also you're going to discuss this with a group of people that have knowledge about this topic, and maybe even preach about this in a way. Of course, you know, the Hierophant is a number 5 card, so it comes with conflict. So if you're telling people what the truth is, sometimes it gets difficult because they again interpret your words maybe in a different way, and you get a different result in the end. Okay, so be careful what you're saying. Okay, even when it's something that people perceive as something very normal. But like, okay, that's normal. But it has an effect because of the intentions behind it that are maybe very emotional. So take some time for yourself before talking about this topic, and that will heal stuff. Okay, so that's what I can see and read for you, Aquarius. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and see you next time.